Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. This is Deep Cuts Reactions, and my name's Greg, and I've got a cold, so if I can manage to do this between my nose running and all that good stuff, that'll be nice. So anyway, I'm going to do a song that I've actually played before, but it was, you know, a couple of years ago, and it's so good. So this is Arlo Guthrie, and he's doing the Elvis song, I Can't Help Falling in Love with You, and this is at Wolf Trap in 93, and I think it's, you know, part of it at least is a tribute to Pete Seeger. I mean, Pete Seeger's in the audience and everything, but, you know, as usual, Arlo tells a great story, so let's listen. Arlo Guthrie.
One time a few years ago, I was over in Denmark with Pete and Tao, and we were playing over there at a folk festival, and it was after the wall in Berlin had come down, and it was a wild time to be over there. There was a sort of euphoric feeling, not just around that part of the world, but sort of all around the world, you know, and it seemed like, geez, thing like things might loosen up a little bit, and people could relax or something. Didn't last for long, but it was a wild feeling. And here we were playing at this folk festival over there, just a small little folk festival, and 30,000 people showed up. And not just from Western Europe, but from all over Europe. Some of them too young to remember a time when they could just, you know, go down the road and hang out in some other town with some other folks, just have some beers and, you know, take it easy or something. So it was a wonderful thing, 30,000 people drinking German beer for 3 days. Singing and laughing and crying. And there was Pete up there, you know, just leading everybody in all these songs that used to be important in this country, you know, a couple of decades ago. All those We Shall Overcome type of songs. And everybody knew the words. And I think they knew the words mostly due to people like Pete, who'd never been afraid to go anywhere, sing for anybody, no matter what their persuasions were, political or otherwise. And it was an amazing moment to just be there. Everything was all right. Everything was fine, as a matter of fact, until Pete looked at me and said, "Arlo, why don't you sing something?" And I realized that Pete had just sung all of the songs I thought anybody might know. I didn't know what to do. I said, "Well, here's one you might know, you know, because there's more than one way that songs gets around. Made popular by that king of folk singers, Elvis Presley." Pete looked at me. Seemed like a nice guy most of the time. He had a look in his eye that said that banjo could get fairly dangerous any moment. We'd been singing them peace and love songs for decades, but folk singers would argue themselves to death years ago over what a folk song was. Didn't stop me or nothing, but I went like this. Wise men say, only fools crash in. Just that far through the song and realized that there was 30,000 people singing along with me. Every one of them knew the words. So Pete looked at them. And I was feeling safer. Then Pete got up, walked up to the microphone. I didn't know what he was gonna say or nothing, you know. He didn't say nothing. Started playing it on the banjo. That's when I realized that Pete knew it too. Shall I stay? Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love? he was, 30,000, drinking, screaming, crying, laughing, singing people. All singing an old Elvis tune somewhere in Europe. Boy, there was something wonderful about that, you know. And I suddenly realized how proud I was to come from a country where our songs are loved and known and sung all over the world by all kinds of people. You know what? Also, I learned a little bit about what folk songs was about and even what they're not about. Because sometimes they're not even about anything. I mean, here we were singing an old Elvis tune that didn't have much to say about the state of the world or something like that, but boy, more was being said by who was singing it and how they were feeling than trying to sing lots of songs that try and say a whole lot of stuff, you know? So maybe you help me sing this old Elvis tune. I'll give you the words, like Pete would. It's easy. Wise men say. Wise men. Only fools rush in. Only fools rush in. But I can't help falling in love with you. But I can't help falling.
They hadn't put those little labels up there so you could see all those kids a little bit more. Yeah, I mean, that performance, you know, he's got a bunch of his kids on stage, you know, singing with him. It's really sweet. But God, that song's just so beautiful. And in a lot of ways, the story that he tells makes it even more emotional. You know, it's just such a gorgeous song that everybody knows. And God, you know, I remember when the wall came down. I don't know if anybody else does, but I remember when the Berlin Wall came down, and it was such a euphoric time. It seemed like things might get better. Like he said, it didn't last very long, but at least for that one little, you know, window of time, it was beautiful. So anyway, I hope you guys like that. I love that whole performance there at Wolf Trap, and I didn't realize that Pete was actually up on stage there, you know, and then did get up and play banjo for a minute, kind of. But yeah, it's a great performance, and I've got several of them out there, and you know, you can go look at Arlo Guthrie's channel, and he's got the rest of them. So anyway, I hope you like that, and I'll be back and play something else. So hit like, subscribe, and we will see y'all then. Bye-bye.